I'm Lisa, and today we're going to be talking about 10 tips that I have for you for time management. And also, if you joined in on a competition last week, then I have the results at the very end of this video. So keep watching, and I've also got a special offer for all of my viewers. So I'm really excited to share it with you. So let's just get started. Number one, to-do list to live by. Make different lists for different subjects weekly and prioritize your tasks. Make sure you complete the most important ones first, which goes into number two. My favorite way of doing this is by using sticky notes, and I will draw some checkboxes and write down the things that I need to do and slowly tick them off as I go. But you have to remember, number two, to prioritize. Often we choose to do the work that is easiest or won't take the most amount of time because it makes us feel good to do something we're good at or quick at doing. And this is definitely a problem that even I do to this day, but I'm actively trying to overthrow this bad habit. Why? Because it can seriously be detrimental to your marks if you aren't facing head on with the task that you find difficult, but it has to be done. So, you need to ensure that you're always completing the tasks that are most important first. Otherwise, they won't ever get done and they'll just pile up in the long run. It feels terrible when you have a big task that is just weighing down on you constantly, like a teacher hovering over your work waiting for you to finish. Even if you finish the smaller task first, you'll only get the big relief when the most pressing task is done ASAP. Number three, use your diary or notebook. Whether it's your school-issued diary or one that you've purchased, they really assist time management by helping you organize what to prioritize first. Using your diary to note down when all your assessments are so you can see exactly what's coming up next is a simple solution, but you'll be surprised how hard it is to consistently manage a diary. You just have to make sure you constantly update it and refer to it on a regular basis. Or you can be like me, and this is a little bit more alternative, and simply use a notebook. I use Moleskine notebooks. Sometimes dates can make me feel worse, especially if I don't manage to finish a task by a certain date that I've set for myself. So what I do is I'll put a deadline next to whatever the task is that I have to finish if there is a deadline for it. But otherwise, if it takes me a little bit longer than I anticipated to complete a project or a task or an assignment, then at least I still feel productive and appreciative of all the work that I've done that day. Number four, turning key tasks into habits. Most subjects require a set amount of questions to be completed for a certain chapter or topic. If this is the case for some of your subjects and you know that you're going to have to finish it and you know your teacher's going to ask you, then turn answering those questions into habits. Maybe choose one or two days of the week, and at the same time on those days, on a weekly basis, turn your focus onto answering those questions. Or if you can't manage to do that, then in your spare time, you know there's always something extra to do, and that includes answering those chapter questions. If you happen to have less questions from school one week compared to more on another week, then use that time to do some revision questions or even exam questions. Number five, make sure you take breaks. When you rush from task to task, you will tend to lose motivation and focus. You really need to ensure that you have downtime to refocus and re-energize. Pomodoro's technique is an effective way to study. 25 minutes study, then 5 minutes off. Tidy's the app that I use to help me time things. This way, I don't have to keep track of the clock myself, but the app will do it for me. It also means that it'll keep track of my breaks too, so I don't get ahead of myself and end up watching YouTube cat videos for another 20 minutes. Even the rest of the night. A bonus tip is that Tide also comes with white noise. So if you like to hear sounds from the city, from the forest, rain, or more, it's all there for you to help you be more productive. Number six, take time for yourself and don't stop doing what you love. Don't forget all the things that make you, you. If it's playing sport, an instrument, or even playing games, make sure you give yourself enough time during the week to enjoy yourself and do what you love. Whilst your major focus is your studies, you can't forget to do what you enjoy. This leads to the next one. Force yourself to take breaks by planning them. I always try to plan some social activities throughout the week. When you lock in these dates with friends, it's a fantastic way to motivate yourself to push through your work ahead of time because you know you don't want to be that person who's gonna bail on all your friends and you don't wanna miss out on doing things you enjoy. Understand the difference between procrastination and taking a break. If you know that you've spent the week studying really hard and you've found yourself ahead of your school syllabus, then you deserve some time off to relax and reward yourself. It might be a couple of hours or even one night, just to not study and do something you enjoy. But If you know you're behind and you're really struggling to finish your work, if you know that there's a day off coming up or even weekends that you have free, make the most of them to get ahead in your work and catch up on what you might have missed the previous week. Talk to your friends and teachers about studying. Their support is truly invaluable. Often you'll find yourself struggling or drowning in work and feeling a little lost. You should always try to talk to someone you trust if you're feeling this way. Otherwise, it'll harm your motivation, focus, and mental health. You'll be surprised to find out just how many others out there, whether it be your friends, teachers who have been in your position, or other people who are close to you who've been through the same situation and felt the same way as you. It's always good to talk to someone who understands. I hope those tips were helpful for you guys. We all have different ways of time management. Some things work for some people and some not for others. So it's really just a matter of figuring out what works best for you. Try all of the different techniques that are out there that have seemed to work for others and just keep testing. One method might not work necessarily for you for the rest of your school year, but it might work for you over the next couple of months, so you might want to switch it up to something different. And I know that's very much so the case for me, so hopefully that extra piece of advice will also make you feel a little bit more comfortable with trying out all the different techniques. If you watched last week's video, then you know that we hit 10,000 subscribers here. So if you're a part of the family already, then that's awesome news. And if you are not yet, then definitely go ahead and subscribe below, because this family needs more willing, driven, and motivated students like yourself. So to celebrate, I held a competition, and that was to win this book here. So this is a book that I co-authored with two other girls, and we essentially made this for year 11s and year 12s in Victoria, Australia, which is the subject that I teach. Congratulations to Natalie! You have scored yourself this book here, which is 100 pages worth of incredible advice and tips from three VCE English high achievers. Thank you to you and all of the other students who participated in this competition. If you didn't win, then don't fret, I haven't forgotten about you. I appreciate absolutely everyone who joined in the competition. So, as a special, what I'm going to do is I'm going to give you a special offer for this book at a heavily discounted rate. Now, the best thing of all is that this is actually part one. So there's actually part two of the series that will be releasing at the end of April. So you'll be purchasing this and the other book, which isn't actually in hard copy right now because we're still in the publication process, but I'll chuck a little photo of it just here for you to see. Part one is essentially the essentials component, which is laying out the foundations, making sure you know the fundamentals, and advanced is taking it to the next step, where it's really pushing you into that A graded level. And in order to get your special offer, just click through to the description box below where your special coupon awaits you. I absolutely love this channel because all of the feedback I get are obviously from students who are really driven and want to learn English and are ready to absorb as much information as possible. So I really hope that the two books in the Ultimate Study Guide Bundle that I have co-authored will be of immense help for you guys. So that's it for today. Make sure you have an awesome week until I see you next week. And thank you so much for watching. Bye.